The Insta360 Link is hands down the best webcam I have ever used. It's made by the company Insta360, and they're most well known for their 360 action cameras. But they're now taking that expertise and they're applying it to webcams. It's basically like if you were to make a wish list of all of the things that you would love to see in a webcam, and all of those things show up in this webcam. You get beautiful 4K images through a 1/2-inch sensor. You can also ensure that you always stay in the frame, even as you move around, through the magic of AI. You could also demonstrate things in front of you on your desk using something called Desk View. Those are just a few of the features that this webcam has. As full disclosure before we jump into this, I received this webcam for free. But this is not a sponsored video, and I'll also share things that I don't like about this camera. Let's start with what you get. The camera itself is fairly small in size. Here it is side by side with my cell phone. The camera is attached to a gimbal, and this allows it to rotate around and keep the subject in the frame. On the base, you have these two holes, and these are the dual microphones, and you use those to capture audio. In between those, you have a tap pad, and if you tap it once, it'll start tracking the subject. If you tap it twice, it'll recenter the camera. In back of the base, you have a USB-C port. The camera also comes with a USB-C cable, and you also get a USB 3 adapter, just depending on which ports you have available. You also get these four stickers, and you can place these in the corners of a whiteboard, and this way you can focus in and zoom in on the whiteboard. You can also pick up an optional $30 tripod that you can attach this camera to. To set up your webcam, you can attach it to the top of your monitor using the included clips, or you could also attach it to a tripod using a 1/4-inch screw. Once you plug the webcam into either a Windows or a Mac PC, it'll just automatically detect it. Here I am in Microsoft Teams, and I see it as one of my available webcams. Of course, if you want to take advantage of the full functionality, they recommend downloading the 360 Link controller software. You can download it directly from their website. Let's open up the software to see what's possible. Here I am in the Link controller software, and right away you see the preview right in this area, so you can see how good the camera looks. And personally, I think it looks pretty good. Now, one of the things I like testing out is how quickly the camera can focus. And one of the neat things is here I could hold something up to the camera, and you'll notice how quickly it focuses on that. Now, when I pull it away, it'll rapidly focus on me again. In the bottom left-hand corner, you can turn the preview on or off. And especially if you want to use this webcam with, say, Zoom or Teams or OBS, you have to turn off the preview in this app before you could use the video feed elsewhere. To the right of that, here you can choose the resolution. And this is a 4K camera, so here I see the highest resolution possible. One of the really neat things is you can also choose portrait orientation. When I select this, it physically rotates the camera, and now I see myself in portrait. This is especially good if, let's say, your audience is connecting on a mobile device. To the right of the resolution, this is where we have some of the advanced functionality of this webcam that truly differentiates it from the competition. First off, we have something called tracking, and when I enable this, this is now identifying my face using AI, and as I move around, the camera physically moves to follow me and to track me. It's not cropping in on a certain section of the photo. It's actually physically moving the camera, and the range of motion is truly impressive. Here, I can turn off tracking by clicking on this button again. To the right of that, we have whiteboard mode. So here, I'll hold up a whiteboard. Remember, order your cookies. And I place these stickers in the corners of the whiteboard to help the camera identify where the whiteboard is. Now I can turn on whiteboard mode. And so now it's looking around and it's finding the whiteboard. And look at this, it zooms in on the whiteboard so my audience can see it very clearly. That's pretty cool. To the right of whiteboard, there's also something called overhead mode. And when I click on this, the camera will point downwards. Right now, it's just looking at the base of the camera. But here, if I pull it out, it'll simply look down at wherever I position the camera. This works especially well if, let's say, you have your camera mounted overhead. To the right of overhead, there's also something called desk view mode. And this one is really neat. Here, when I click on desk view mode, the camera rotates to about a 45 degree angle and it'll show whatever's on my desk. So here I could write some notes or I could demonstrate something and my audience will be able to see perfectly. And it also uses tech to adjust the image so it looks like an overhead shot. This one's pretty impressive. Now that we've looked at some of the special modes, I also want to show you how you can manually adjust the image. Right up here, we see the preview of me. I could use my mouse to adjust the position of the camera. So here I could pan from side to side. I can also use my mouse wheel to scroll in, or here I could scroll out. That was a little bit close. Right over on the right hand side, I can also use these controls to make slight modifications to where the camera looks. Or here I can make more drastic changes to the positioning of the camera. Over here, I could also zoom in and out, and this goes a little bit quicker than using my mouse wheel. So let's say I really like this shot right here. I mean, it's got me centered in here. It looks good. Right down here, I can click on this plus icon, and this will add it as a preset. So this way, I could jump between my presets very quickly simply by clicking on these different buttons. Also, once I'm all done, and let's say I want to go back to the zoomed out, just default view. Right up here, I could click to reset, or I could simply double tap on the camera, and that will also reset to the default position. When I'm all ready to record right down here, I could either take a screenshot by clicking on this button, or to the right of that, I can also record a video. In the top right hand corner, I also have some additional settings that I can configure. Here, I'll click into image settings. And here I can adjust things like the exposure, the white balance, and all these different settings to get the image to look exactly how I want it to look. On the far right hand side, I also have more settings, and these are some really interesting ones. Right up on top, I have gesture settings, and here I could use a gesture to kick off different modes on the camera. Here, for instance, I can hold up my palm, and this kicks off active tracking. I can also position my hand in an L. And this way I can zoom in by lifting up my hand, or here I could lower it to zoom out. And I could also jump into whiteboard mode. So lots of different options there. Down below, I also have some tracking settings. Here I could adjust the tracking speed. I could turn on auto tracking simply by positioning the camera at a subject. So here I could manually position the camera to look at me, and then it knows that it should track me. I could also simply position myself in the camera, single tap, and then it'll know to track me. So there are lots of different ways that you can turn on the auto tracking mode. Down below, this is one of my favorites. There's also something called AI Zoom. Here, I'll turn this on. So the AI automatically detects where my head is. Here, I'll turn on tracking mode. And now when I lean back, here you'll see it zooms in and frames my head within this shot. Here, if I switch to half body, it'll zoom out a little bit more. So the software understands and identifies the different parts of my body. And then you also have the whole body option. Down below, you also have many other settings that you can configure, so well worth looking at what you can do with them. Up on top, one other setting that I want to call out. If you click on the ellipsis or the three dots, here you can also access most of these features just by using hotkeys. So it makes it really quick to access all of this functionality. Once you exit out of the app and you're no longer using the camera, it'll automatically go into privacy mode where the camera points down and it'll no longer pick up any images. One thing that I really like about the Insta360 Link is that you can use it together with many different third-party apps. To use my Insta360 Link in an app like Microsoft Teams or any other app like Zoom or Discord, simply go down to where you can select your camera. Here, I'll click on the settings gear. And right here, I can choose my camera. Make sure to select the Insta360 Link. You can also choose the Insta360 Link as your microphone. Now, before you turn on the camera in the third-party app, make sure to go back to the Link Controller software. In the Link Controller software, in the bottom left-hand corner, make sure to turn off the preview within this app. Back now in Microsoft Teams, here I can turn on the camera preview, and here I see the feed from the Insta360 Link. Now, one thing you might be wondering is, well, how can I zoom in, or how can I turn on the different modes? Let's go back to the Link Controller software. In the Link Controller software, in the top right-hand corner, we can click on this icon. And this turns on miniature mode. Down here on the bottom, I have this mini bar that gives me all the primary controls of the Link software. Here, for example, I could launch my different modes. I could jump to my different presets. So I have all of these same controls directly in whatever app that I happen to be using. You can also use your Insta360 Link directly in software like OBS Studio. And this is perfect for streaming to, say, Twitch or YouTube or Facebook. Right down here, simply click on this plus icon and select Video Capture Device. Here, I can select my device and I'll pick the Insta360 Link and then click on OK. And right here, I see my image directly in OBS. If you're interested in learning more about how you can use OBS Studio, be sure to check out the video right up above. Down in the bottom right-hand corner, here I could start streaming, or here I could start recording, so many different options. Lastly, you could also use the Link together with NVIDIA Broadcast, and this really enhances the functionality of the camera. You could use this if you have an RTX graphics card. Right here, I have the camera selected, and you can apply all of these different effects to your image. Here, for example, I could blur the background, and this gives it this really high-end DSLR look. Down below, I could also apply all of these other effects to my video. So it's another way to enhance or extend the capabilities of the Link webcam. All in all, this is the best webcam I have ever used, but there are some drawbacks. The first one is that you cannot use this with Windows Hello to log into your Windows PC. To be able to use that, you need an infrared sensor, and this camera does not have that. The second thing is it includes some built-in microphones, and they're pretty much what you would expect for a webcam. They get the job done, but they're not amazing. This is what the audio sounds like directly through the webcam. If audio really matters to you, you'll probably want to use an external microphone. Lastly, and probably the biggest deal breaker, is the very steep price for this webcam. It's significantly more than most other competition in the webcam market. That being said, you get a lot more functionality. But maybe the tracking doesn't matter to you. Maybe you don't need desk view. Maybe you don't need a 4K camera. If that's the case, this camera is likely overkill and you could find something cheaper. All right, let me know down below in the comments, what do you think of this webcam? At least for me personally, this is going to be my primary webcam moving forward. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I'll see you in the next video.